Good morning dear students and welcome back to Science 1. We have already started the lesson work and energy and we have already finished with try this activity. Okay, fine. Now today I am going to explain about solved examples. Now though they are solved in the textbook, you need to know how they are solved. So that is why I am making this video to make you understand how it is solved. Okay. Fine. So let us see the example number one, that is calculate the work done to take an object of mass 20 kilograms to a height of 10 meters. Fine. So you need to find out how much is the work done, and you know by formula work done is equal to force into displacement. Fine. So now here in this case, if you just see, two things are given. One is mass, which is 20 kilogram, and second is displacement, that is 10 meters. Now there is no force, right? So how you need to find out force, that we need to understand first. Fine. So here for work to be done, you need to know both force as well as displacement. But only displacement is given, force is not given. So how to find out force? So if you remember, you have already learned in the first chapter, second law of Newton, that is the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the impressed force, that law. So in that law you have already learned about the formula, you have derived the formula for force, and that formula is nothing but force is equal to mass into acceleration, correct? That is m into a. Now here you might be saying that how a is there, here a is not there. But if you see in the brackets below the question, g is equal to 9.8 meters per second square is given. Now why this is given is because if you just look at the question carefully, it is given there, if the object is taken to a height of 10 meters, okay? So that means we are talking regarding the gravitational acceleration. That means when an object is taken to a height, that means we are, you know, seeing the acceleration which is, you know, going towards the earth, and that is nothing but the gravitational acceleration. So always remember the the quantity, that is gravitational acceleration, is always 9.8 meters per second square. Yes, of course it depends upon the height of the earth and all, that is different case, but here on the surface of the earth gravitational acceleration is 9.8 meters per second square. So here now you have got the mass, that is 20 kilograms, and second now is the gravitational acceleration, that is g is equal to 9.8 meters per second. So now you can substitute this value, that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. So you can write in this manner, given is nothing but, you need to write first what is given here in this case. So what is given is mass is given, mass you need to write like this, mass is equal to 20 kilograms. So remember kilograms is a SI unit, so you need not convert it into grams. Fine. Then what else is given? Displacement is given as 10 meters, and we have g is equal to 9.8 meters per second square. So if you remember, acceleration is nothing but rate of change of momentum, rate of change of velocity. Fine. So that is v minus u upon t. You have already learned this in the previous chapter. So that is why the unit is meters per second square. Fine. So now let us see now what we have to find out here. You have to find out what force first, because we need in the formula work is equal to force into displacement. First we need to know what is force, because only displacement is given, force is not given. And to calculate force we have the formula mass into acceleration. Now here there is gravitational acceleration, so it is m into g. Fine. So now let us write down what is given here. Mass is 20 kilograms and g is 9.8. Fine. So now here when you calculate 9.8 into 20, or you can directly multiply 98 into 2. So because here there is one decimal, zero is there, you can take this when you multiply, this point will come here. So the 98, when you multiply with 2, the answer becomes 196. And the unit of force is newtons. This you have already studied in standard 8. So 196 newtons. Now there is one more thing here to be told. Now since the force acting is of the force of gravity, that is in this direction. Fine? And you have taken an object to a height in this direction. So force and displacement are in, you know, opposite direction, like this. Fine? Since both of them are in opposite direction, the sign becomes negative. You have already learned this previously. So here the force is negative force, that is 196 newton. Fine. Now let us calculate, let us substitute this value of force in the formula w is equal to F into s. Okay, fine. Now we have got already what is force. Force is minus 196 into 10 meters. So the answer becomes minus 1960 joules. Now, since both the units, that is newton and meters, are in SI unit, now SI unit of work is joules. Whereas you have already learned this previously, and CGS unit is erg. So since both of them are in SI unit, that is newton and meters are in SI unit. Fine. So the unit of work becomes joules. So this is regarding the first problem. So only thing you need to write here, negative sign, is just to indicate that force and displacement are in opposite direction. Fine. So this is the first problem. Now let us go for the second solved example. So let me rub this. Second solved example, let us see example number 2. Praveen has applied a force of 100 newtons. So force is given here, 100 newtons, on an object at an angle of 60 degree. Fine, now here angle x comes. So you should remember that the force and displacement are not in the same direction. So here you have to use the formula W is equal to Fs cos theta. Fine. So at an angle of 60 degree to the horizontal. Fine. And that means it is this way. Angle is around 60 degree. This is the force and this is the displacement. Your displacement is in the horizontal direction and this is the angle theta is equal to 60 degree to the horizontal. The object gets displaced in the horizontal direction. Okay, so object is getting displaced in this direction and 400 joules of work is done. So work is given here. We need to find out what is displacement. How much is the displacement in this case? So 400 joules of work is done. What is the displacement of the object? So what things are given, that we need to write first. What is given is first always write down, and here it is given cos of 60 is equal to 1 by 2 or half. Fine. So let us write down now what is given here. So given is equal to theta is given as, that is angle between the force and displacement, that is theta, we are taking it is 60 degree. Fine. Then force is equal to 100 newtons. Okay. Work is given as 400 joules. 400 joules. And what you need to find out is small s, that is displacement. Displacement is equal to what? So for this we will use the formula work is equal to Fs cos theta. Now cos theta over here, theta is equal to 60 degrees. So we can write the formula as Fs cos of 60 degree. Fine. So now force is 100 newton. So here you can write 100 and even work is given. So we can side by side, we can write work is equal to 400 joules. And where also you can write at the same time, right? 100 into, we don't know what is displacement, into cos of 60 is 1 by 2. So you may know, simple equations. Okay, simple equations. You need to take this 100 this side. So when you take 100 this side, since it is multiplied, here when you bring it, it will become divided. Fine. So here it will become 400 upon 100 is equal to s into half. 4 s into 1 is equal to s upon 2. So you, when you cancel 400 and 100, 100 ones are 100, 100 4 the 400. So the answer becomes 4 is equal to s upon 2. Therefore, s is equal to, you can take this s this side and 4 that side. S is equal to 4 upon, when you take this 2 this side, it will become multiplied, it get multiplied with 2. So it becomes 4 into 2. So the answer is 8 meters. Okay. So this is the displacement of an object when the angle between the force and displacement is 60 degree, and when the force applied is around 100 newtons, work done over here is 400 joules. That means the displacement is 8 meters. So I hope so you have understood these numerical problems. When it comes regarding the solving of the exercise, at that time you should be able to solve the numerical problems. So in the next video you are going to learn about energy. Fine. So let us continue in the next video. So thank you, dear students.